welcome to Delhi, where we are poised, ready for a busy second day of shooting competition here at the Dr. Karni Singh Shooting Range. Three finals today. We got a air pistol, 25-meter pistol. They are to come, but we start with the 50-meter rifle. Three positions alongside me, Sharu Charma, who took me for a walk around Delhi yesterday evening. Not quite here, though.
No, unfortunately, it's not. It's one of the better landmarks, the more visible, beautiful landmarks of Delhi, the Baha'i Temple. And of course, take your pick when it comes to monuments. Many centuries, so much heritage, and none, I suppose, more famous than this one right here. The Qutb Minar, all of 230 feet and some, built over almost 100 years, 1200 and some AD. So it's taken some weathering. But of course, all the action here at the Dr. Karni Singh Range, remodeled, refurbished before the 2010 Commonwealth Games, has a lovely finals range now, and even the shotgun, there were three ranges added on. So a wonderful facility spread over 80 acres in the southwest suburbs of New Delhi, a huge city. Yet yesterday we certainly had a fair amount of local representation. So we are live, the ISSF World Cup rifle pistol event here in New Delhi.
Yeah, it's a busy schedule of events over the next few days, and that's how it's lining up. We've already had the air rifle for women, and let's hope everything else is as exciting as that. Today, the 50-meter rifle, three positions, the 10-meter air pistol, and then back a little bit for the 25-meter pistol for women. That's today's, and a few more days to go as well.
Well, all eyes will be on the 10-meter air rifle for men. That's tomorrow, the 25th of February. As always, it's likely to be very close, very hard fought in the center here. Randhir Singh, India's long-term representative at the IOC, former, of course, chief of the IOA secretary as well, the Asian Olympic Association as well. So played a very big role. Olympian himself and an Asian Games gold medalist, Randhir. I'm still on to him. But this is from yesterday. What a terrific contest, Richard.
It certainly was, wasn't it? Eight athletes battling it out to be on the top of the podium for the first event of the World Cup for 2019. And well, Apurvi Chandela was the home favourite, the home hero. Everyone hoping that she would continue her serene progress to the top of the podium. She started slowly, but it was others who were making way. Justed of Norway, Hirata then disappeared. And when they got right to the end, it was Zhao Rozhu of China against Chandela. But she, I think, averaged 10.5, I was reading. That's absolutely astonishing throughout that competition.
Well, not much of a celebration, and she later did admit that she's not huge in celebrations. There's a mother, she was right here at the range watching Apurvi take gold. So a big start for the home contingent, but I suspect medals will be few and far between in the future events today onwards. But a terrific start for India. It's always nice when the home nation does well. Here we are with the 50-meter rifle three-position men about to start.
Yes, and unfortunately for the home nation, no Indian representation, but we've pushed back the barriers and we're out. You can just about see the sunshine. 50 meters is the range. It's the rifle for men, of course. And this is the lineup with some real good contenders in here, Charlie.
Without doubt, Istvan Peni, such a celebrated shooter, plenty of medals at the international level at the World Cups. Also, Klaus and DiNicolo, plenty of medals too. And by the way, Clausen, the only one who's got himself an Olympic quota already, I think. So here's Randhir Singh again. Let me just confirm that for you.
I think it's Kamenskiy.
Kamenskiy,
who won
pardon,
in the air rifle in a previous competition.
So true, you can win in Korea, beg your pardon.
Absolutely. Each nation can win up to two in this. There are two qualifications for the Olympics played in each competition throughout this year as well as we head towards Tokyo. And as you can see from these the pictures of the crowd on this Sunday here in Delhi, from around the world, a big American contingent, as always, of course, the Russians here. And it will continue to grow as the competitions flow through today.
Yeah, plenty of the compatriots in the stands, but I'm sure more locals will troop in as we go along. There's certainly supposed to be a fair amount of Indian contention in the events to follow.
And this is a big part. You don't really think about this if you're just watching it, but of course they wear a special suit, certainly the rifle shooters. It's made from canvas. It's stiff material, obviously. The idea is to keep you fairly stable as you're trying to shoot. And they are handmade, as you would expect, obviously, for each athlete. And they are not the cheapest things you'll ever find. And they do sweat when it comes to taking them through the airport, making sure it arrives at the other end, because this is like an extension of your arm.
True, it's all custom made and very heavily regulated, if I can say so, because the rules of ISSF are very specific in terms of clothing. No extra support at all in terms of whether it's the foot or the legs or the arms. And there's Kamenskiy.
Suits you very nicely, sir. Of course, the boots as well, certainly heavily regulated, a certain standard expected. Wow. And of course, in three position shooting, they won't have it all on. Certainly tight at the beginning. It just depends. The standing is the last one. Of course, that's what they want the suit particularly for, so they can zip at the back there, just give themselves a little bit of flexibility whilst they're kneeling, and then in the prone, of course, as well. And we'll talk you through it, because there's a lot of changes. It's quite a technical. This is perhaps one of the most technical of the events you'll find in the shooting calendar. They come with a big box full of stuff for them to change around when you change from the kneeling to prone, and then from prone to standing. Change your sights, you change all sorts of things, and obviously you adjust your clothing. And the rules are, if you've forgotten anything, it's not in that box, then I'm afraid you don't have it. So check, check, and then check again.
Well, they can get pretty obsessive because of all that checking. But yeah, it's the magic box, and there are plenty of changes for all three positions. It's all very, very precise, as you can imagine. The sport of shooting, and they're all fabulous athletes as well, so there's a lot of fitness in terms of preparation, particularly for this event. Not easy, kneeling can be a little rough, and of course the prone's a little easier as far as I go, but standing again, very tough.
Yeah, the prone when you're lying down should be the best scores you will see, but apart from that, it is a tough old competition, and as you said, it's like a marathon, or perhaps like a 10,000 metres. It takes a while to get towards the point where people are leaving,
it's only for the official.
And then it happens quite quickly. So it's all a question of getting your mind right as well. And as you can see, these custom-made rifles, 5.6mm rifle, maximum 8kg. And they're not the cheapest things you're ever going to get. And if you come to a World Cup, you'll see outside of the finals hall lots of people from the different manufacturers and lots of athletes milling around, seeing what's new and what they might want to improve, perhaps just a little percentage of their performance. So a little bit of a carnival outside as well as inside the finals hall. Barrel and stock stay the same throughout this competition, but the sights and all that sort of thing can change and will change, because of course they are in a different position. It's a very, very individual thing as well. Just going through some preparation now and some sighting time. The idea there is you get an idea of just how in tune with the rifle you are and how you're going on with the shots and whether you need to adjust the sights as well.
Okay, well, that's a lot about the equipment, and we'll continue to hear about it. But right now we got Jamie Stangram down at the ground ready for the player introduction.
Well, good afternoon, New Delhi. Namaste. So, welcome to day two of the ISSF World Cup here in the aforementioned city of New Delhi, country India, planet Earth. We have got our three positions men's final taking place in just a matter of minutes. And this is how it's going to work for anybody new to the sport. So we will have three different types of positions, hence the title, who knew, kneeling, prone and standing. We're starting off with three series of five shots in the kneeling position. As you can see down there, that's the position that you're witnessing through your very eyes. And those will be fired in a time of 200 seconds per series. We'll then have 7 minutes of changeover and sighting time, which will be followed by three series of five shots in the prone position. They'll be fired in a time of 150 seconds. Per series. Then we have 9 minutes preparation for two series of five shots in the standing position. Now, after those two series, our first two eliminations will take place. So athletes placed in eighth and seventh will leave the competition at that point. We'll then have single shots fired in a time of 50 seconds, still in the standing position. And after each single shot, another athlete will leave the competition until the bronze medal has been decided after shot 44 and silver and gold medals after shot 45. If we have a tie break situation at any point, then additional single shots will be fired until that tie has been settled. So that's how it's gonna work. Obviously medals are up for grabs, but also quota places as well. So athletes placed in first and second have the opportunity to take a quota place away from New Delhi or with them, which will obviously go towards Olympic qualification in Tokyo 2020. Just one exception, and this isn't us being mean or anything, but Sergey Kamenskiy of the Russian Federation isn't eligible for a quota place today because he's already got one. He bagged it in Changwon at the World Championships in 2018, so congratulations to him. And you guys have a role to play as well. It's a long final. I like to say it's the final that was written by J.R.R. Tolkien. It goes on for a long time, so we need energy from you guys as well, because we are broadcasting live to the world, people. I'm told something like 75 countries, more than 75 countries, potentially more than one galaxy as well. We're going intergalactic, baby, with this. We're also on Facebook as well. We'll be streaming live on the ISSF Facebook page, YouTube page. I believe we're live on YouTube. Also, you'll be able to rewatch the finals as well in both of those places. Photographs as well being taken. Familiar face here, Nick, the official ISSF photographer. He's taking the pictures that will go on the website. Also, the ISSF Instagram account as well. So, yeah. Not good energy so far from you guys at all. Disappointed from Norway on the front row here. Normally such a lively bunch. Yeah, okay. It's going to be a long day. I do have exciting news, though. For those of you that have followed these competitions over the last couple of years, I can exclusively reveal that the first exciting ISSF quiz of 2019 will take place during the second changeover period. So if you know what I'm talking about, now's the time to probably try and escape the finals hall or stay and compete, because prizes will be available. We've been getting athletes to go head to head from various countries. Norway have been represented. In fact, we have a former champion, Henrik Larsson, here on the front row. India have been represented in the past. Sweden. So I will reveal more about this, the exciting prizes that are up for grabs during the first takeover, and we'll choose two contestants as well.
So the sighting time still continues. Jamie Stangram just ensuring that all the spectators here are well entertained and kept abreast of everything that is to follow. Interesting about that quiz during the second changeover. Richard, get your facts right, because
you're challenging me, are you?
Well,
you probably
we will have an internal
fair
competition here. But we're all waiting for this very exciting final. Unfortunately, no Indian,
athletes,
as was mentioned
position,
earlier,
but heads and faces
confirmed that Parul Kumar finished 22nd at 11.70, which is just a few points less, and Sanjeev Rajput 25th. Sanjeev Rajput, of course, a medalist at the international level, but it wasn't to be his day today. Failed to make it through to the final. We are now almost ready for the player introduction, which will happen again.
And unlike a lot of the events, they don't stand up and face the crowd because they are ready in that kneeling position, but they will acknowledge the crowd as they can.
All right, we are now ready to have the eight finalists formally introduced by Jamie Stangram down there.
Ladies and gentlemen, the organizing committee of the ISSF World Cup New Delhi 2019 and the International Shooting Sport Federation welcome you to the Dr. Karni Singh Shooting Ranges. The final competition for the 50-meter rifle three positions men's event will now begin. So let's meet the athletes. On firing point A, representing Italy, the world number 10 has competed at 4 Olympic Games and has a grand total of 9 World Cup medals to his name, the most recent coming last year in Munich. It's Marco De Nicolo. On a firing point B, representing the Republic of Korea with 10-meter air rifle World Cup silver from Gabalar 2015. Today is his first final at a World Cup in the three positions. Let's welcome Kim Sang-do. On a firing point, C, representing the Russian Federation. He's a titan of this three positions event with 3 World Cup final medals, 1 bronze, 2 golds, and 4 World Cups, including gold in Changwon last year. It's Sergey Kamenskiy. Moving on to firing point D, representing Italy. The 20-year-old picked up World Cup Junior gold at Seoul in 2018. This is his first Senior World Cup, therefore his first final. It's Marco Supini. On to firing point E, representing Hungary. He's the current world number 6 with 10 World Cup medals in total, 4 coming from this event, consisting of 2 bronze and 2 golds. It's Istvan, Peni. Okay then, we're moving on now to firing point F, where we have, representing Italy. The young shooter took Junior European Championships gold in 2013, and today is his second final at a World Cup. Looking to better his 4th place from Fort Benning is Lorenzo Bacci. Moving on to firing point G, representing the Republic of Korea, with 10-meter Olympic silver from Rio 2016, and also silver in this very event from the London 2012 Olympics. He's looking for his first 3 positions at World Cup medal. Here today is Kim Jong-un. And finally on firing point H, representing Norway. He's appeared in finals in other disciplines at both World and European Championships, but today is his first 3 positions final and debut final at a World Cup. So let's give a Delhi welcome to Simon Clausen. Hello, Norway. So the jury member in charge of this final is Mr. Hamid Ibrahim Hamid of Sri Lanka. And the chief range officer, here he is Mr. Hamid Ibrahim Hamid of Sri Lanka. Let's give him another round of applause. The mystery man has revealed himself. All right, so the chief range officer for this final is definitely here, and his name is definitely Mr. Saeed Tosif of India. So there we have it. We'll let the final begin.
Thanks to Jamie. And those are our athletes who are just getting themselves in the zone now.
Take your position.
Well, it's been tough enough to get here. About 100 competitors, only 8 make it to the final.
And this will be followed by 3 series of 5 shots in the prone position.
So the kneeling to begin first.
Yes, we start with kneeling. 3 series of 5 shots, 200 seconds per series. Then 7 minutes to change over. We'll talk you through what they need to do. They go to the prone position, the lying down on your stomach. They've got it in layman's terms. 3 series of 5 shots, 150. It's a little bit easier. It is the easiest position, then 9 minutes is the most difficult transition from prone to standing. And then, well, after we get down to the 8th series, the first 2 leave, and then after each shot, there is an athlete who will leave until we get to that 45th shot, and that decides gold and silver.
So till 40, everybody's together. And then I'm afraid they do settle for lesser
for
positions.
For the first
as it
competition
were.
Series, load.
Final instruction to load, and we should now start the final here.
Start.
At the Dr. Karni Singh Ranges. I wonder if there's a little bit of a hint of a butterfly in one's stomach or so, especially those who made it to the final for the first time.
Well, you saw Faison there, looking very, very focused indeed. The very experienced athlete. From Norway, what did he know, 27 years of age, world rank 40. He's got a lot of competition. The Italian's very strong, of course, 3 in the competition with Di Nicolo, Supini, and Bacci as well. And they will take their time, 2:45 still on the clock. It's just over 3 minutes that they have to get away the 5 shots. It sounds like you have an age, but actually some people take it right up to the up to the limit. It just depends what your style is.
Well, who's jumped off the blocks is Kim in position B, qualified second best, and Kim Jong-hyun, that is.
And Kamenskiy started with a 9.9, but he's just getting back in with a 10.4. I did notice during the sighting that he was high and to the left, but the sighting shots, exactly what they're for. You can adjust your sights, make sure that they're working the way you would like it, and look at the calmness of these athletes. And look at that, 10.9 wow. for DiNicolo. Well, we know what he can do. He is one of the favourites here, the 42-year-old man from Arconate in Italy, a man who's been to four Olympic Games and no doubt will make it five next year.
Just to remind everybody, at Changwon last year, Marco finished second behind Kamenskiy, which is where Kamenskiy got his Olympic quota. And Marco finished third again in Munich, that was last year. So he knows how to win. Marco knows how to get into the finals, very experienced. But do watch out for Kim Jong-hyun, because he is an Olympic silver medalist, London 2012. Rio, he finished 16, but he started out in great style. That's on position B. There he is, done very well so far. 10.9 again. Wow.
Well, Peni is struggling. He's had one which is in the eights as well. Last one for him was 9.9. So the Koreans certainly showing how it's done, and some of the Europeans just struggling a little bit at the moment, but Marco DiNicolo is looking good. This is Clausen, who isn't having quite it his own way.
Yeah. Stop.
I think for him.
Well, that was our first series of five shots frustration. In the leading position. There were two 10.9s, one for DiNicolo, also wonderful kick.
Here we finished our first 15 shots. And there's a quick look at DiNicolo and Kim. Right on top. I was talking about Kim Jong-hyun. He didn't finish quite as strongly. As you mentioned, Richard, Istvan Peni, for the moment, right at the bottom, so he hasn't started out too well.
For the
just
next
one
competition
in the
series.
10 ring. No. We are talking 50 meters away, of course, so it is a hellish difficult thing to do. So we've got through the first series of five shots in kneeling. Two more to go in this position, and then we'll have the changeover to the prone, and we'll talk you through that. Fairly technical. As you can see, the sight is a very, very precise sight. The cheek plate there as well, that will move a little bit as well as they change their position. And Kamenskiy with a 10, Supini with a 10.2 to get us underway. Now 9.4 from Bakke, so and Clausen with a 9.6. you saw him there still struggling by the look of it.
Well, Peni has certainly tried to better his score in the second series of five. Neil, he's gotten a 10 to begin with, but it's not easy. 50 meters away, and on a very close-up, you can take a look at the fact that the gun does shake just a bit. But that's being unfair, because the naked sight doesn't move at all. They're still very focused, all the competitors. Peni, 10.7, so that will certainly help him move up.
Clausen with a 10.8, he's certainly looking much better. And there he is. Still a bit of work to do, but it's such a long haul, this competition, that if you can get your mind back and sort yourself out. He was in the 9 ring before that, and then to go to a 10.8. They know, they've got the monitor just to the side of their shooting position. Kim Sang-do, well, he is looking really good, a 10.8 from him.
Well, he's the less experienced of the two Koreans.
That's what the athletes can see. They know where their grouping is, and they know how they're getting on. Back to Clausen. Now watch the trigger finger here, just caressing it.
Just a light feather. So Kim Sang-do continues to do very well. World ranked 95, so He is a new kid on the block, as it were. And if he can actually get a medal here, that'll be fantastic for him. And for Korea, his much more celebrated compatriot in position B is Kim Jong-un. He started out very well, but as we saw after the first five shots, dropped back quite a bit. So he has a bit of work now if he wants to get back into the top three or four. But it is a marathon, Richard, so plenty of time still. And yes. There's no point despairing over one bad shot.
Absolutely. Klaassen better this series, but still spraying it around top and bottom of, I say spraying around, it's all a relative term, to be fair.
He's still
struggling a wee bit, but he's got up into fifth place, and it's still very tight at the top. Danilo, Kim Sang-do, Kamenskiy in the mix as well, and Bakji, well, he's there or thereabouts. But as you can see, Supini, Kim Jong-yong, which is a bit of a surprise, yet to break the 100 mark.
Well, Klaassen also competing in his first final, so we can understand Klaassen and Supini might take a little bit of time to get used to the final, but Kim Jong-hyun certainly a surprise, and Peni, as you said, moving up to fifth, so he's clawing his way back, and we are almost ready now for the third series of five shots.
Well, you want to be averaging 10 or above, that's for sure. So the last series of the five shots, clock ticks down from 3 minutes and 10 seconds. There's one either side, and also on the monitors for the athletes as well.
It's a shame because of the sun, we can't really see the targets. There's too much light out there. Our cameras are not able to catch the targets, but they are very far away and very tiny. So just a quick look at that trigger finger. Very, very light touch.
It is a long way. There's not actually that much to see if you're a spectator. There's a little black dot, but these can see more. Kamenskiy certainly seeing it well. 10.7, his first shot as well. Some of the others struggling. Peni with a 9.4, Bakji with a 9.9. Kim just hitting the 10 ring after a 9 as well.
When these guys have to be steady and very cool, but if you take a look at their demeanor, their look, they just are so focused, so steady. It's a delight to see.
DiNicolo, that was a good first shot from him, a 10.7. And now look at the trigger finger just easing it. You all know he'll have his own routine.
Bakji doing well.
Well, it's a lot better. That's his third shot. The other two in the 9 ring, so he needed that shot, that's for sure.
It's quite amazing how nations seem to specialize, even the world of shooting. European nations certainly very, very good at the 50-meter three position. Hungarians, Istvan, Peni, the Italians.
Absolutely, and standing out at the moment here is Kamenskiy, who certainly has been hitting the 10 ring. As we say that, he just hits a 9.9, but there you go. That's one of the, he's world ranked 8. And Klaassen coming to the party a little bit later. He's hit a couple of decent 10 shots. That one, they're in the 9s. And that's the view they have. And it is difficult from the cool, dark interior. We open up the shutter to get to 50 meters. On the far left-hand, right-hand side, you can see some targets will be rolled across for the 25-meter pistol later on as well.
I'm looking forward to that for sure. Well, that's much later. For now, this marathon continues. Klaassen on the far left, and one to watch out for is in position B, Kim Sang-do. As I mentioned earlier, world rank 95, but he's done very well to stay in touch with the leader. And we'll check after this final set of three sets of five in prone position. How will we finish?
Yep, Supini, his first senior final. And sat up, he's done and dusted. I think we're all done and dusted with, what, 25 seconds left on the clock.
And look, and, 7 minutes,
DiNicolo looking good.
And Klaassen time
from seventh up to fourth. So he will be very happy as he gets ready.
To go. So that's it for the leveling.
Minutes now, we'll talk you through that in a minute, but let's have a look at how they're standing after that first series.
Very disappointing for the big man, Istvan Peni, at the bottom of the pack once again. He had climbed back up in the second set of five, but unfortunately couldn't quite pull in the last set. Some disappointment for fellow celebrated shooters, Kim Jong-hyun, who have been talking about the silver medals at the Olympic Games, second from last. But let's focus on the top. right. Dinikolo, fabulous start. Well, stayed well. Kim Sang-do also. He's only 0.3 behind. So that's very, very close. Another 0.3 behind Kamenskiy, who has less pressure because he already has the quarter. But still, this is a different event, and you want to be on the podium.
I kind of wish I was on commission from the world.
This is what they're doing at the moment. We'll just confirm how they are at the moment. Dinikolo just ahead of Kim Sang-do. Kamenskiy shooting well. Klausen really hitting some form. And of course, some of these athletes will be more comfortable in one position than the other. A lot of these guys will have, you know,
an awkward
medalist
5 to 6 minutes or so trying to find two people to take part in my
rotor of
exciting ISSF quiz, which
has
toured the world.
Team events,
we've given away many prizes.
This is really what this and the attendant rifle is what they
probably not very good for the environment, but we have
and this is what they're doing. 7 minutes to get ready, their rifle ready. There's that very precious box full of bits.
For the winner of my quiz,
the mat comes out into lie on. They loosen all their clothing to make sure that they can lie comfortably.
Sites,
you've already seen the sights changing close. And very quick
Gabala.
To change the sight on the
all
end
of
the barrel.
That
all changes.
People.
The barrel and the stock, of course, have to stay the same. These is stipulated,
and you could be,
but they're going to lie down, so the head can't be as high on the rifle.
To go head
and that's
to head
why the sights have to change.
Quiz.
Yeah, it's very technical. And of course, they have to sweep all their shell casings away.
It's
all robotic, really. They know exactly what to do, and of course, in doing all of that, they have to ensure that they don't get worked up. They still have to remain very cool, keep their pulse nice and relaxed.
Well, that's the thing, because the 7 minutes includes the sighting time. So what do? You get changed really quickly, get your pulse rate up, and then give yourself enough time to bring it back down? Or do you do it calmly, methodically, but not give yourself as much time for the sighting? It's one of those things that as an athlete you've got to work out.
Yeah, just my call, though. Would be to take it easy because they've shot, well, I'm not saying millions, I say it symbolically, they've shot thousands of times. So that they're aware of, they know they've done well. 50 meters is 50 meters, plus there's some slight atmospheric conditions. But I certainly would not want to. Physically,
there we are,
seeing some of the changes. But physically, I'd want to be nice and relaxed rather than.
We're friends,
hurry
yeah?
it up, get my pulse up a bit, and maybe ruin the first two or three shots. Just under 4 minutes still left, and at least one or two of the shooters are ready.
Yeah, well, it's the sort of thing that you will practice a bit like a sprint team in athletics will practice the baton changeover. They will practice this. They will make sure. I mean, there's no point going to the shooter if you're not ready. This is as important as the shooting. And now, you watch the breathing now come down. This should be easier. There's more contact with the ground. There's less movement that you can't control. It comes down to the breathing at this point. And also the position
also
you're in. So you'll see one straight leg, then you'll see
the
other one
slightly
top. And it is just a question of calming yourself down, getting ready for more shots. We're on the three series of five shots and 15 shots all together. 150 seconds to get those series away, each series.
So we're just going back to show you some of the highlights of kneeling position. First 15 shots. Not as easy as prone, but a little easier for sure because you've got a few anchor points on the ground than the standing, which is really tough. And that comes last. So at that point of time, the scores tend to be a little more ragged than the first two.
The next changeover, I'm going to do a quiz.
Dinikolo started out in great fashion.
Where's the
good
best
shots
place
Kim
Jong Hyun
as well. At that point,
cameras.
I thought, well, maybe he will live up to his reputation. But he faded
minutes.
Away.
And I'm going to do like a silly quiz.
Celebrated
with two athletes
compatriot.
In the audience.
Korean.
Where shall I stand at 1 o'clock your cameras?
Kim Sang-do, but two sets still left. Or two positions still left. So there's plenty of shooting. The big disappointment, Istvan Peni, who finished at the bottom to begin with. In the second set, he climbed up to fifth. We thought, oh, the big man's now racing ahead, but unfortunately his final shot of, set of five shots also didn't quite work out, and he finished at eight in the kneeling position. But I still expect him to claw his way back.
Well, he is world ranked number six, of course, the man who has gone to a World Cup final here in New Delhi. What was that, back in 2017? The kind of hierarchy of events, World Cup's really important. World Cup final, That's a little bit more important. World Championships, we had that in Changwon, of course, at the end of last year. That's really important. Only bettered really by the five rings.
Yeah, true. You know, ultimately it's the Olympics.
It's Jenny, not Yenny.
Within your sport, the World Championships is very, very important. But it's showcasing your talent amongst all sorts of other sportspersons. And the Olympic Games have their special charm in here. We've got only Kim Jong-un who's done very well. Even De Nicolo, who's participated in four Olympics, and Jamie was talking about that earlier when he was introducing him. Beijing 9th, London 15th, Rio de Janeiro 27th, Athens all the way back 31. So he's been to four Olympics still, unfortunately, he's not podium. So maybe the way he's going now, he still has opportunity in Tokyo.
Well, and you know, we're talking about him being a veteran, still world ranked number 10, 42 years, 4 months, and I think 22 days, if I'm really precise. Thanks to our friends at the ISSF who provided with that information. He'll be going to a fifth Olympics. He's 42 years of age. Compare that to yesterday, the 10 metre air rifle for women. Excuse me, there were three teenagers, a couple of 20 year olds, and well, a real veteran at 27.
I have no doubt that some of those teenagers we're going to be seeing at the Olympics in 2020 and maybe on the podium as well. There are a couple of Indians, Vandu Bakker, who was only 16 when she started winning major international medals. So they're getting younger and younger. And that's the big thing about the sport. We can be as little as young as 16 and as old as 40, 50 and still be winning medals. So it's a pretty unique sport in that regard.
There does come a time when people say, yeah, my eyes have gone. And I think I'll just coach, thank you very much.
Yeah, but nerves have also gone, perhaps.
If you're good enough, you're young enough, and possibly old enough as well. So that is good in this sport. We like that very much. So the sighting situation is over. We've gone from kneeling to prone. The athletes should be ready. A long puff.
Yeah, we'll expect better scores, that's for sure. So, De Nicolo topped at 154.2. Kim Sang-do at 153.9. I suspect that will go up for all the shooters in the prone position. And we're waiting for final instructions to start the three sets of five shots.
Kamenskiy looking anywhere but at anybody else. Looking at his monitor, just looking the near distance.
For the next competition the series, load.
Okay, here we go. Instruction to load, and then the action begins.
Start.
Less seconds, but it should be enough. It's 2 minutes and 30 seconds, 150. And we are underway with a 10.1 for Bachi. This should be much better. Sabini with a 10.7, Peni with a 10.6. We should be seeing higher scores. There's less variables. They're much more stable in this prone position.
Kamenskiy, so unfortunately, starting with a 10.1. Sorry, Richard. So he is going to drop back just a bit. Klausen with a 9.9. Now, that'll be very disappointing. Did so well in the kneeling position that you'd expected a better start here.
Well, he's a slow starter by the looks of it. Certainly has been in this competition. And it is. I mean, some of these athletes will be better in different positions. And it is a question of, we'll only really know once they stand up and we'll get towards the point where people have to leave, having been ruled out.
I shouldn't say my man, but Istvan Peni begins with the 10.7, so he's obviously much more comfortable in the prone position. Such a veteran and knows how to win.
Kim is suffering a wee bit. And that is Kim Sang-do, 9.7. He's struggling to hit the 10 ring. Kamenskiy is looking much more comfortable, it has to be said. He's there or thereabouts with De Nicolo. And there was one poor shot from him, but that 10.7 really hauled him back into contention.
10.8 for Sabini. Bit of a surprise for me. Not as celebrated as the rest. Of course, the nation itself, Italians, have produced many celebrated shooters, but Sabini started out very well here in the 50-meter three-position final. Sure, well, he's lining up for a podium position. Still too early, though.
Well, first senior final to get on the podium. That would be outstanding. There's his compatriot, Bachi, who is just composing himself. He has really shot very well. You may well have already shot. We've got just under 30 seconds left. Remember, have to get a bit of a shake on in the prone position because it's a little bit easier. Well, there you go. Everyone has shot. We still
that
got
was our
20
series
seconds
in the
on the clock.
Let's take a look at what.
And the Italians
on
top of
the
pile. Not Sapini, as we said.
Well,
his
no
last shot has hauled him up into
table,
fourth place. It's still Di Nicolò.
He had a total
and
of
Clausen back down into seventh after
joint
a really poor series.
Well, it does help that Istvan Peni is much more comfortable in the prone position. Once again, moves up to fifth. And Kim Sang-do moves down to third as Kamenskiy takes over that second position, but Marco Di Nicolò has done virtually nothing wrong, so he increases his lead, but two sets of five shots still left, and as we've seen, there could be plenty of turnaround in positions during this stage.
Yeah, we're getting towards the halfway mark. It's 45 shots to gold, and we are on shots 21 to 25. Kamenskiy, nice with a 10.5.
Bacci, the surprise, a 9.5. That can really push you back.
Temporarily pushes him down into
How
seventh.
About Kim, 8.3.
But at the other end, Peni looking very calm with a 10.8. It really is moving around. Like you say, 8.3, disaster is too strong a word, but at this high level, it is a very poor
shot.
I could
go with disaster, really, 8.3. That's a good 1.7, 1.8 less than average, as it were, if we can derive an average being, say, 10.
And back to 10.5. So something happened. Something happened. Who knows what? Very unusual. You see just a little adjustment of the sights there on position F for Bacci. Just not happy with his last shot, which was a 10. So it's not terrible, but not brilliant. So just
maybe
adjusting, if he thinks, and the last two have been a little bit down to the right, to the bottom to the
over
right.
Over-adjustment, perhaps,
so
because
he'll
he was
readjust.
High
yeah, absolutely.
In centre yep. earlier.
And now he's low into the left. So, you know, it's one of those where you've just, you don't want to be searching at this point. That's what the sighting is for, the sighting moments.
Yeah, but Marco Di Nicolò, 10.8, and he continues to race ahead. It could be a start to finish for him, which is rare. But obviously he's in terrific form.
He is. I mean, silver in the World Cup in Changwon last year. He'll be happy with that. A gold, of course, in the 10-meter air ride for. He has stood on the top step of the podium on the World Cup. That was way back in 1997. That's how long his career has spanned. Well, people getting into the swing of this now. The shooters. Still a strong Sapini with a 9.5, so followed by a 10.5. So it's being a little bit random. Kim is struggling.
Yeah, a little patchy.
Kim Sang-do.
Which is strange for prone. Can you understand being patchy, particularly in the kneeling?
Clausen, you saw there, has had a very good series. He's back up to back up to fifth now. Still Di Nicolò. And that lead has increased over Peni, who has overcome and taken over Kamenskiy to take second place, but it's still a long way to go. Very close between certainly second, third and fourth.
A quick look at those who've graced the occasion. Ranthir Singh, bottom center, Olympian, and of course long-term representative, official of the IOA, representative of the IOC. Well, the big surprise was Kim Sang-do slipping to number 7 from number 2 as he began, then went to number 3. And equally surprising, but pleasantly so for him, Istvan Peni moving up to number 2. So he is far, far more comfortable when it comes to prone than perhaps kneeling. We'd speak for him, we shouldn't, but maybe he just started badly. But Di Nicolò racing away.
So the last series of prone, and then we have a 9-minute pause, not for the athletes, they won't be pausing, they'll be racing to get ready for the standing position a little bit longer because it is a more complicated change for these athletes. Oh, there you go, can't get better than that. Bacci really is happy with that, and that will hopefully start to haul him up the table a little bit. In a bit of bother at the moment, Di Nicolò, he's certainly found his range, hasn't he?
Well, he hasn't put a foot wrong, or should we say a bullet wrong. Done very well throughout the competition so far, and it's up to the two Koreans to see whether they can claw their way back up. But Kim again has had a series of very poor shots. Well, they're two Kims, so let me clarify. Kim in position B, that's Kim Sang-do. What a shame, because he started out in great style and just cannot now find bullseye.
He's been quiet, but he's certainly after the last series whizzed up has Peni, and another 10.8 from him. He's looking really good. The man who is, of course, world ranked number 6, just 22 years of age though. And we said a bronze here in New Delhi in the World Cup final a couple of years ago, so he likes this range. Some people like different ranges, you know.
Yep, there's a bit to say about geography as well, but Peni, we saw a shot of him earlier on, continuing to try and somehow catch up with De Nicola, who continues to not miss a beat. So I just wonder if De Nicola has done too much already to take gold here, but I'm jumping the gun. Still plenty of time left. Final set of 15 shots standing.
Kim Jong-un finding a little bit of belated form. And I think we're done for that series of shots. Certainly a little tap of the foot from Klaassen. He's done and dusted.
9 minutes.
And there you go. As soon as they're allowed to change over, they will get to it. That's how it looks as we set ourselves to get ready for that last series. And De Nicola, Peni and Supini are those in the middle positions at the moment. Klaassen, though, again, he's slowly, slowly from 7th or 8th in the early series is clawing his way back up again. And Kamenskiy, who was top of the pile, slipped down to 5th. So it just shows, as you say, Charu, this is a marathon, a 10,000-metre race. It certainly is not 100-metre sprint.
So this will give them 2 extra minutes over the 7. They have 9 minutes to change over. Lots of changes, by the way, in garments particularly, and of course a bit on the gun too. But just a quick reminder of the standards we've seen, or the turnarounds that we've seen. They've been quite remarkable. Istvan Peni saying, finishing at 8 and then 5, then back to 8, and then now pulling his way onto second spot, just behind De Nicola. Here's the magic box again.
And here's, you know, so that is the little belt that they use to attach to the rifle friends. When they're kneeling, when they're in the prone position. So you've got to change, and here we go, you've got to bring your screwdriver, take different sights, so one sight comes off, another sight comes on. Again, your head position against the rifle is different, so this is going to be a little bit of a higher one. Thank you. Come to me. Coming back to the old site, get it where you like it as well. Just and all this, bear in mind, whilst you're wearing that very expensive canvas suit that restricts your movement.
Hello, welcome.
Yeah, well, they do move a little awkwardly because of the stiffness of the clothes. But it's almost like an engineering exercise. These guys must be mini engineers. The kind of precision that they have to use to be able to change their gear.
And the thing is, you've been lying down for a few minutes, so your muscles naturally relax. And so now you've got to get yourself ready. And of course, that's where the suit comes in. It helps because you've got to tense your muscles. You've got to calm yourself. You've got to steady yourself as well. So that will cause problems for them. That's why they're in the gym, making sure they're tip-top and ready to go. And why De Nicola will fancy his chances. But you never know, someone else may fancy standing just a little bit more than the other two positions. So you have to control that swaying, of course. That's why they got the suit, and they will tighten it up nice and tight. Of course, you still, after all this, got to give yourself at least 2 or 3 minutes of sighting time as well.
We have sighting time, I think just calming down time, because there's so much emphasis ISSF in the sport of shooting on breathing, on ensuring that you're at your calmest, no stress, no nerves at all. Easier said than done when you're changing equipment, moving positions.
High stakes. Don't get
trust your gun so much. We go back to showing you some of the highlights of the prone position where Istvan Peni showed his class, moved up to second position.
Kamenskiy was struggling, wasn't he?
The pressure's away from Kamenskiy having made his well. Very unfair thing to say because each event gives you an individual medal and is in terms of individual bragging right there. But having made or having gotten the Olympic quota, he just somehow takes the pressure away, minimally perhaps. He started out very well though.
Absolutely, and we will see who fancies standing. It is the more difficult, you will get lower scores.
If you get it wrong,
it's interesting to watch these athletes during the highlights. You can see around the face, you can have the caps to keep any glare away. Some people actually also like the plastic shields, just so you don't get distracted. Some of them just depends on what you like. Here you can see there is an eye that is being. And Kamenskiy as well has that little plastic shield to block off the non-shooting eye. Not everyone wants that, but some will as well.
Well, there's plenty of time left, but at least a couple of the shooters are ready for the standing position. Di Nicola, one of the first to get ready.
Shooting sport and first introduced plenty of time
to get their sighting organized, to get their
1896
breathing
B,
control so important.
That's Peni who's just getting himself sorted. Of course, you want to stand in the right place as well. And you've got to make sure that everything is tightened up. Those jackets will be tightened up. The gloves go on.
Well, just in the background, very quickly, we check the site of Mount Everest. So we've got this huge panoramic mountain view. And just right behind there is Mount Everest. So is that symbolic of reaching the Everest of your sport or what? It's a wonderful
Everest. It's beautifully appointed above the athletes. They have shots of various monuments of Delhi. It's beautiful to see. These athletes won't be worrying about that, obviously. They will be worrying completely about their sighting time, getting everything ready, but still 4 minutes. And remember, they've got to block out people like Jamie, who are keeping the crowd entertained. For them, they've got the chance just to keep themselves calm, get a lot of sighting shots. You do need more time for sighting because it is more difficult.
Is the right answer.
From,
it's 1-1. Norway 1, Romania 1. Let's
hear it for Prone. And, you know, if you need, you know, more sighting shots, you might use a different bullet or...
Look,
might, the sight
person,
certainly will have moved. And
these
is a very good view of...
Sarcastic, okay?
There
so
you go.
All have to
the very tight
together.
Canvas
this is a happy moment.
Jacket that you have to wear.
Question three.
Well, just a reminder that the clothing is very heavily regulated. They have to check everything in, make sure that it's all approved,
we're in India,
and they must not change it thereafter at all. The key thing really is to have
no
extra anchor.
Yes, you are. You don't get a point.
Lower
for that.
Limbs, the upper
well,
limbs.
I just wanted to be clear. We are in
because
India.
That would be unfair.
But
so it's all very heavily checked. You go through the ISSF rules. They are very detailed.
What is
I suppose
the
they've
the
looked
river?
After every or considered every possible
Indus.
Option. And put it out so that there can be no ambiguity.
Even the shoes are regulated, so they are quite solid soles, but they do check the flexibility. There is a little
right
machine
answer.
There
Norway,
to check
back
the
in
flexibility
the lead.
Of
Norway.
The soles because it can't be too solid. It has to be a level playing field, and that's what they make sure.
Question four.
Exactly.
According to the
no
Guinness
extra
Book of
anchoring,
records,
no extra support.
The man with the most
and yet, of
the
course,
world.
These clothes being a little heavier than usual do give you a little bit of stability, that's for sure.
Watching the shooting, watch the recoil as well from these rifles. The amount of recoil depends really on the ammunition you are
32.
Using. Some like
B,
a lot of recoil,
26.
Some like less.
Or
it's
C,
all about the touch,
37.
And you can feel that kickback. That's the recoil. And if it recoils straight back, that suggests a good shot. If it's wiggling about a little bit, that suggests that it's not so good. That's the best way of trying to work out without seeing the scoring.
Minimal movement, but among the three positions, quite obviously, this is the toughest because when you're kneeling, there's a little bit of extra anchor. When you're prone, of course, plenty of anchors. But when you're standing,
the
left hand particularly, that bears quite a bit of weight. Is the tricky hand and the back too, because they're all what's the word? Convexed, I suppose, or concaved. And very often you hear about shooters with back problems, and that's primarily because of this position right here.
It's a very unnatural position. That's right. You're arched backwards, and it's not natural. And it's interesting. You know, there are so many different variables. I was at the Commonwealth Games in Glasgow back in 2014. I saw this baby being passed around the Canadian team. And I said, oh, who's the baby? And they said, they pointed to their practicing, to the shooting range.
What's that baby
over there? She had the baby 2 or 3 weeks ago.
Wow.
And I spoke to her and she said, it's really difficult because until recently I was 9 months pregnant. And that's one way of balancing. And now it's a complete, I've got to reassess how I'm shooting. And it didn't even cross my mind. That might be a factor, of course.
Do you know what?
Well,
we haven't got time for the topic question, so I'm sorry about
that. Extra advantage.
Yenny is the winner.
Stability.
That's a round of applause for Yenny.
Unless
but
the baby starts kicking, perhaps, anyway.
But a quick reminder that these guys need to be extremely fit. I think those who may not be very closely concerned with the sport of shooting need to realize just the lengths to which these athletes go to ensure that they're absolutely fit for top-level competition. We're almost through with the time now, and we should be finishing our final series pretty soon.
It's very true what you say, Jerry. And even on the outdoor ranges for the rifle competitions, perhaps a little bit stout to some of the gentlemen, but do you know what? They've been qualifying for hours and hours, and then they have to go to a final. So there's a lot of stamina needed in all the shooting events that the ISSF cover.
So everything looks pretty static, but let me assure you, physically, they're very dynamic, these guys. And we mentioned that standing, this last series of 15 shots, so that'll be for the finalists. After 10, of course, we'll start peeling off the positions. Gentleman who finishes 8th will have to leave the arena. It's always a depressing moment. You've done so well to get to the final, then you have to leave before all the rest finish.
And this is why we're talking about like a 10,000-meter race. You know, we've been lapping. They've been some better earlier in the race. So this is where it starts to speed up and people make their break if they can. And all of a sudden, it gets quick, this competition. People are leaving all over the place. So stay with us. Don't go anywhere.
We're ready. So from the left, it's Di Nicolo, then Kim Sang-do, who started well, finishing badly now. Sergey Kamenskiy in the middle somewhere, not doing too well. So Peni, the Italian, doing well. Istvan Peni in E position. That's fifth from left, doing very well to move up to second. And then Bachi, Kim, and Clausen on the far right in position H. We're set. First set of 5 shots. Standing position. 3. Position 50 meters, men's final.
Well, you saw Di Nicolo getting ready on the right-hand side of your screen. Slight nerves. You saw the trigger finger slightly shaking, but once it's on the trigger, he is ready.
Di Nicolo on 9.6. And I have to say, compared to Prone, where we saw some fantastic scores, it's going to be difficult here. However, Istvan Peni gets a 10.6.
And that is really good when you're standing 50 meters away, remember. And these guys, they are swaying. They will, and it's a question of just working with it and your breathing. And you can see there, just massaging the trigger.
Light touch.
Yeah. And you see how much higher the sights are for the standing. Obviously, the head position a lot higher as well. And some of these guys are shooting well. Kamenskiy with two really good shots to get him back up into third place at the moment. Kim at 10.7.
Yeah, Kim in position H finally comes up with a 10.7. He's been a big disappointment at the final so far, but you never know. He's got 10 shots to come right back.
Well, you wouldn't really put much money on there being a chance of both the Koreans being the athletes to leave after the first time that it happens, after the 8th series.
Back to Di Nicolo with a 10.7. So they've had one bad shot to begin with, but he is right back, hitting almost center of center, 10.7 for the Italian. And Peni is not fazed by that, comes up with another 10.7. Istvan Peni.
I'll tell you who, there are a couple of athletes who are suffering. Clausen, 9.1, and only just a 9.1, and only not in the 10 ring yet for Clausen on the far right, as you can see, getting ready to take his next shot. Sapini also suffering a little bit as well. The Koreans, a lot better. They're certainly looking okay. But whether it's a little too late, we'll have to see. Kim Sang-do. Certainly a 10.6 is his best so far. He's been a bit average, actually, some of the other shots in the 9 ring.
Well, 9s are a little more common while standing, so perhaps that's not shocking. What's more shocking is the 10.7s, 10.8s. They are absolutely brilliant when you can manage a late 10. Peni doing rather well again.
Yes, he's grouping really well. Everyone else is a little bit random. A little aid memoir of where they're actually shooting. A 10.7 from Bachi. That'll help him no end. Puts him up into fifth at the moment. Still just over a minute left of this series.
Bachi finally with a 10.7. So he's been all over the place on the target in terms of grouping, but he'll be happy to get back right to the center. 10.7. The Italian slipping just a bit. But the one who's really slipped is Di Nicolo, a 9.1 at last. So the Italian is certain to give up his lead after this first series of 5 shots, we think.
That's a 10 from Clausen, by the way. You saw him, and he's last to shoot. Got 250 50 seconds, the longest period in the series of all the different positions. Well, there's a reason for that.
There we are, Richard. So Istvan Peni now does move up to first spot, as I thought he would. Di Nicolo gives it up after being after leading from the front all the way through. Is now 0.5 behind Peni, 0.8 behind, that is.
And Kamenskiy
moving up the Russian.
I think that Kamenskiy held on during the pro. Not his favourite by what the scoring would suggest, but now I think we might see his class coming through.
Also, among the two Koreans, Kim Jong-hyun moving up to the sixth position, so he will look to better that and maybe somehow get back into medal contention, although he's pretty far away from the moment.
And Clausen at the far end there, again, starting the series in a different position, very, very slowly. And this is not the time to do it, because this is the eighth series of shots. And after this, two people will leave. And then we have people leaving after each shot.
Well, so the people in trouble, of course, Kim Sang-do, who began so well. He's at eighth position, needs to pull his way back up, and Clausen as well. And just above him, the other Korean, Kim Jong-ho. So those are the three in trouble. A few tens will help.
Yeah, the two Kims, they're quite interesting, actually. Kim Jong-un at 7.9. Meanwhile, the other Kim Sang-do, at 10.8. So differing, you know, fortunes. And there is the lucky Kim, perhaps, or the skillful Kim, who at 10.8 from him. And that will keep him in contention. But both at the moment, both the Koreans, will be the two to leave at the moment. They've got to do something these next couple of shots.
Well, Kim Sang-do certainly helped his cause with that 10.8. But Kim Jong-hyun, our Olympic silver medalist, continues to be in a dangerous position right now. Simon Clausen has done well, the Norwegian, to try and move out of the last two spots. But again, it's all very tight, and I'm sure the tension is now rising among the HU, certainly the bottom three or four shooters.
And Kamenskiy certainly creeping up, not far away from Peni as well. Clausen with a 9.4 to follow a 9.7. But Kamenskiy, here he is. This is a man who knows the way to the podium, that's for sure. Although I say that, commentator's curse, he shoots a 9.1.
Well, it's tough, the standing position for sure. And of course, they've been at it for a while, so there must be a little bit of wear and tear as well. Kim Sang-do in danger of taking no more part in this contest, but he's done well, another 10.8. And it's his more celebrated compatriot, Kim Jong-hyun, who is certainly looking at an early walk away from the finals arena.
I tell you what, he's not hit the 10 ring so far, has Kim Jong-hyun. Kim Sang-do, and he's into sixth at the moment. It's Simon Clausen, who again, 8.5, his last one. And meanwhile, Di Nicolo is on the left-hand side of the shot, as you can see him there. He is doing enough to stay in contention.
Which is a bit of a surprise, yes, correct. Here's Clausen in danger. Perhaps his last shot, see whether he can be bailed out.
Now, a conversation between the judge and the jury, and that's a malfunction, I think, that might be having. The range officer will come and have a look. Now, you can have allowable and non-allowable malfunctions. And, well, I wonder what is going on with that Sapini, who's in fourth at the moment.
Well, he's done very well, Sapini, in the contest so far, to stay somewhere in the middle. Well, currently fourth, but he does seem to have a problem.
He's talking to the coach. The safety has gone in, and I wonder whether that is that, because if the equipment fails, then there's not much you can do. In rapid fire, sometimes ammunition jams and you can have a malfunction, but it looks very much as if, and that's what a terrible thing to happen. If he can't sort the rifle out, he will have to take eighth place.
Well, we keep hearing about such situations that happen in major competitions, and of course it's a big blow, but you wonder, with so much precision, with the fact that the equipment is absolutely top of the world, yet at times there is some hint of a malfunction, but he looks like he's not going to be able to continue, or is he?
Well, the other thing you've got to bear in mind is the clock is still counting down, and so he might be out of time anyway. And that will drop him down.
Stop.
Well, the clock is at zero. Yep. Sorry to interrupt there.
I think so. He's not completed. No,
well, he still looks kind of bemused a bit, saying, well, I mean, how could this possibly happen to me? But do I just have to sit back and take the call of the jury?
Yeah. Bear in mind, this is his first senior final as well. And that's a terrible way for it to end if it is going to end like that.
Shall I wait?
There is conversation taking place down there with the Italian coach. He has having a conversation. The range officer is also having a conversation.
Yeah, well, there's also a lot of such discussion provided in the rules of the ISSF, so I'm sure they'll take the right call based on hard facts and objective matters. But Sapini is only 20, so he's the youngest shooter here, and what a shame if things were not to work out for him in this 50-meter three-position final here in New Delhi.
Absolutely, he's not moved, and that's for sure. His rifle, well, just the way he's standing would suggest that that rifle is not going to be usable.
Ladies and gentlemen, taking eighth place in this final here today, representing Italy, put your hands together for Marco Supini.
Well, what a shame for the youngster from Italy.
I feel terrible for him because of perhaps a malfunction.
Seventh place has been decided as well with a total of 401.1 representing the Republic of Korea is
well.
Kim Jong-un.
Well, that is
Jong-un,
a surprise,
Olympic
isn't it?
Silver medalist. Now, that's a big surprise, although
congratulations
not
on
the final to suggest
place.
That he might have gone for a podium position. So they are the two who have now walked away. Six left.
Top gear now because after every single
we continue
shot,
to
have
another competitors leave the arena.
And bear in mind, it's just, just a single shot. So we've gone from a marathon to a sprint all of a sudden.
In fifth place.
Coming around the bend.
And it's Clausen who's trailing on that bend as well.
Closer than at the top, Peni and Kamenskiy now, not to Nicolo. Are vying for one and two, but of course things can change because the scores vary widely when it comes to the standing position, as much as a point and, each at times.
I will be astonished though if Clausen isn't the one to make way and take sixth. This is the man under pressure, the 27-year-old from Setskoba.
Oh, Di Nicolo at 9.5, so that won't help the Italians' cause.
An 8.3 from Clausen, and he knows already that his race is run.
Taking a sixth
Kim Sandu
place,
with a 10.7
Norway
will
help. Kamenskiy's
done really well. Looking very cool now, the man who already has his Olympic quota. But applause for Clausen as he makes his way away from the arena.
So we have a
well, his highest ever in the World Cup before was 18, and that was last year for Ben. So his first final in the World Cup here in this discipline, and he will be happy enough. Disappointed, of course, but something for him to build on. So now we look at who's next and who's in danger, and that is Kim Sangdu. But he's only 0.3 behind Lorenzo Bacci of Italy. And we'll see who will be.
0.3, Richard, is nothing when it comes to the standing discipline. Like I said, maybe a point and a half at times. So Kim Sangdo, who's shown plenty of ability, he leapt off the blocks when it came to the kneeling position. We'll try and get the better of Lorenzo Bacci. We'll see. 0.3 behind. It all comes down to this one. Who's going to be fifth?
And look how different it is. They're set up. Look how hard that cheek plate is on the Koreans.
Wow, Kim Sangdo has certainly done enough. A 10.7 to Bacci's 10.3. We'll see whether that leapfrogs.
And his last shot is a 9.7. And that, well, he, like you said, he had a 10.7. You thought that would have set him up. But it's not enough. And Kim Sangdo of Korea is the next person to leave. He will take fifth place.
Well, it's been up and down for him, started out really well, second position, and we thought he might carry that forward into a podium finish, but he has had to settle for fifth here in the 50-meter rifle three-position for men final.
And although he has a silver in the 10-meter air rifle back in the day, that's his first final in this position. So I think, you know, they'll be happy enough with that. 31 years of age, takes fifth.
Now the true heartbreak, Richard, because you do all this hard work, you're just one position position away from hitting the podium, from hitting the victory stand. And unfortunately, one will have to settle for fourth. And it could be Bacci, who's currently fourth. He's only 0.4 behind Marco De Nicolo.
It's an all-Italian shoot-off for fourth, in effect, because they are quite a long way, 4.6 behind the top two, who are tied at the moment.
Yeah, in a sense, it'd be such a shame if it's De Nicolo who walks, because he's led the field almost all the way through, but now in a little bit of danger. He hasn't shot very well at all, but neither has Bacci.
And it is Bacci who shot a 9.3, who drops down into fourth position. De Nicolo with a 9.8, not great, but enough.
Just well, some nerves there, but because of that 9.8, it does appear that Marco De Nicolo will not vie for silver or gold.
Do you know what?
Bacci will settle for bronze.
Bacci, his best position so far in the World Cup, in Fort Benning last year, fourth.
Back again to fourth.
How with 10.8
annoying for him personally must that be?
We'll have time, but now we get to the final three. So already gold, silver, bronze, but to whom? De Nicolo, we think, will definitely be bronze.
I would have thought so. He's 4.6 behind, and a point between Kamenskiy and Peni. Well, that could go either way. They've got two shots, of course, to battle that one out.
Here's Istvan Peni, who's done very well to claw his way back up from being at the bottom of the field after the kneeling position, and he liked prone. He got clawed his way all the way back up, but between him and Kamenskiy, who's also come back very well, there's only 1 point. De Nicolo, well, we think he'll certainly take bronze unless he does extremely well, and the other two don't.
They haven't spent too much time thinking about it. Kamenskiy with a 9.3, and that means that with Peni and a 10.2, just 0.1 at the top, but in third place, confirmed as bronze medal, Marco De Nicolo.
The bronze medal representing
he's going to be
Italy
announced off.
Goes to
Marco
De Nicolo.
Started really well before he might do a start to finish. But he seems happy enough with the bronze.
With a 10, and then a total
looked
4.5.
In good position for a different
World
colour
Cup
earlier on.
In total,
but it's third and it's bronze for De Nicolo. Yet another World Cup medal. Now,
place for Italy as well.
Final shot
to
decide gold and silver. Remaining.
By the way, the Italian, it is another World Cup medal, but it is the first in this. He's got gold in air rifle before now, way back in 97. He's his first. Third medal for him, silver, bronze, and now another bronze as well. So
50 meter three position. Okay, this shot now, and of course, Jamie down there is announcing the fact that it's the last shot.
And it's 0.1 for the next competition shot. So after this marathon, it really is a dash for the tape.
The final few steps. Who's going to breast the tape, as it were?
Who's got the mental strength as well as the
Istvan
ability?
Istvan Peni
well?
For me.
Okay, let's see.
Only 0.1 behind.
World rank number 8 against world rank number 6, the Italian.
Plenty of noise among the spectators. Oh, a 9.8.
It's but enough, though.
Shoot to world, but enough, but 0.1 to take him through. Wow. Drama. The final shot here, the 50-meter three-position rifle final in New Delhi.
But
the competitors
both
know each other very well.
Goes to Istvan
celebration.
Peni
takes another gold. He's done that on several occasions
as well
last year as well, the year before. Such a celebrated shooter, and Kamenskiy,
well,
no less.
Well, what a dramatic Sergey finish to a long event, of course, the three-position rifle. And in the end, it is the world number 6.
As well, and we're just
Peni,
getting our three medalists together.
Who, of Hungary, who takes it, 22-year-old. So,
one,
you know, a lot to come, a lot in the tank for this young man. And the Russian Sergey Kamenskiy having to settle for silver.
Let's meet the winners.
Both of them, I think, a little bit nervous that final shot, but that's the podium for this three positions, 50-meter rifle for men competition.
Peni just about remembering to take that
eyeshade
away.
The malfunction.
This is the medal representing
congratulations
the Russian Federation.
Done very well. This is a marathon. Yeah, we might call it a sprint to the finish, but it is a marathon. And pretty bruising too, physically.
Absolutely. Bear in mind, they've had a very, very, very long qualification process as well. A long day, I think, probably a long 2 days for these two. But as you say, bronze for Italy and Marco Di Nicolo. Sergey Kamenskiy.
So there we have it. Congratulations to all of our medalists and all of our finalists. Well,
Hungary triumphing.
The people of New Delhi as well. But it's not over yet. We have not only two more finals to come in the finals hall today, but we have the victory ceremony for this final taking place. In
Fort Benning last year,
Gabala the
year before that as well, and that is how all eight of them lined up. And you have to feel a little bit for those who went early on, certainly for Marco Cipini, who is not actually 25 points worse off. It was just that he had a malfunction on his rifle, and there's nothing he could do about it.
Yeah, but confirmation about the Olympic quota, so Istvan Peni makes it, and so too does De Nicolo. Kamenskiy already had his quota position. Yep. It's the gun as well, but it's you too, Istvan Peni. Just 22, wonderful smile. And his compatriots come and congratulate her. Fine, fine performance. Just a reminder that he finished the kneeling position in virtually last place and then to claw his way back up to goal. What a fabulous comeback.
Yeah, and he'll know what his strengths were. You wouldn't have panicked early on. As we look at the highlights of the last section of this three-position final, and like you say, mentally you've got to be aware of where you are, but perhaps also block it out and just concentrate on the shot in front of you, because all of a sudden we're dropping people and there's only two left, and the gold, before you know it, is organized and sorted, and the celebrations have started. And there, of course, that was really sad to see that Cipini had to retire with a malfunction. It wasn't perhaps Clausen's day either. The Koreans would be disappointed with how it went for them today as well.
Yeah, for different reasons. Kim Jong-hyun, of course, more celebrated as the Olympic silver medalist, so he went early, and then Kim Sang-do had started so well, so he'd be disappointed that he finished relatively poorly.
And of course, one shot inside gold over silver, there was 0.1 between them, and it was in effect a shoot-off, wasn't it? All smiles from the medalists, though, it has to be said.
Well, the end of massive effort. Let's also not forget the qualifying. So plenty of work there. Then to come to the final, to handle the pressure, the crowd, the music, and of course all the rest of the top shooters of the world. And Istvan Peni's done really well. Some relief. I sense a sigh there saying, whoa.
Be happy in the heat of Delhi to get all that kit off as well, probably, and get into something a little bit more comfortable. And that's what they'll be getting ready to change, getting ready for the medal ceremony, of course. And as the celebrations continue, we will prepare ourselves for the celebrations and the conversations to be had.
Well, there they are. Yeah, a little more animated than the young Indian lady yesterday. Apurvi Chandela just sort of smiled a bit and said, well, thank you very much. But at least a raise of the gun, a fist pump, as it were. Istvan Peni thoroughly deserves this gold medal here today in the first event. Remember, of course, many other events today. Two more finals coming up. We'll take a short break now and we'll come right back. Hopefully, we'll be close to the presentation ceremony. Don't go too far. Welcome back to our coverage of the ISSF World Cup at the Dr. Karni Singh Ranges in New Delhi. A refurbished range. Of course, they've now put a board across that 50-meter mark, so we've got a little bit of shadow here, but the sun's out and pretty effective here in New Delhi. Fine weather, though, generally speaking. I'm Charu Sharma. I've got Richard Drew here with me, and here's confirmation about the 50-meter three-position rifle event, the final. The Hungarian Peni taking gold by only 0.1 off the last shot against Sergey Kamenskiy of Russia. How dramatic was that, Richard?
Well, after an hour of watching him shoot, come down to the last shot, it was really a very, very interesting, very exciting final here in New Delhi. Peni from Kamenskiy, who seemed to be good friends. Kamenskiy, a broad smile, even though he just lost out. De Nicolo will be very happy. He was a bit of a country mile away from the other two, as it turned out. Wasn't to know that, as he arrived in the finals hall an hour or so earlier. Started, of course, with the kneeling series of shots. Very, very flexible these athletes have to be in terms of their mentality to go from kneeling down to prone and back up to standing. Very also technically adept at changing your sights. You know, need to, no one else can help you. You've got to help yourself. And, well, it was a very high-quality final, as we said.
Without question. I think the two Koreans will be disappointed, the two Kims. And of course, disappointment for young Clausen as well because of the malfunction. But Sabini did well to a large extent, so did Bacci. And Sabini, I beg your pardon, was the one that had to bow out too early because of a malfunction. I asked you, Richard, about how such fabulous, what should we call them, otherworldly guns can malfunction. That too in a final can be heartbreaking.
Do you know what? I've covered quite a few events. And in the rapid fire, you do see malfunctions. That's more to do with having to get the ammunition out and through in a burst. Here, I don't recall it happening in the final. And of course, there's nothing you can do. There is nothing you can do. And for it to happen so close to the end as well, when he was in the mix, certainly not to be, having to drop out so early on. That first final as well. Yeah, it's
pretty
very unusual.
And I must congratulate him for the kind of composure he showed despite the malfunction. I'm not suggesting that he was leading towards a medal, but certainly a much better show. And then to finish the way he did, I think he handled it very well in a very mature fashion.
Yeah, I mean, he didn't know at this point when he was in the prone position. Clausen, the man who flattered to deceive, he sort of would come good and then fall back again.
But it was this man, Marco De Nicola, who led from the front, kneeling as well as prone, I think, and at that point of time just looked so steady. But maybe the final position is not his best, but also he had to contend with the talent of Istvan Peni.
Well, a lot of these guys, they would have done a lot of I think it's fair to say they would have done a lot of 50 meter prone rifle competition before that's not become not an Olympic event. So that's where they're comfortable standing, unless you're coming from the 10 meter air rifle. It's not your strength. So you can always tell there are people who are stronger and they won't be particularly fazed by being in the pack or towards the back. As long as you're within, touching distance, you won't worry too much. So that, these guys who won were those who could keep themselves calm and go through. And Penny certainly hauled himself up during the standing phase of this competition.
Well, considering how badly it began, we have to congratulate Istvan Peni for taking gold here. Very, very special effort. So we will confirm the results of the 30-meter three-position rifle and hope that you will continue to join us because there's plenty of other action, two other finals to come. Here's just a reminder of the two Kims moving away from competition. All a bit of a heartbreak, but they take it with good spirit. And eventually, Marco De Nicolo finishing third seemed to be happy enough with the bronze, although he led most of the time. And this was the last shot to the left. Kamenskiy, who seems happy enough with the silver, and of course, Istvan Peni taking gold. So let's confirm the score here. It's Peni taking gold by only 0.1 and gets his Olympic quota spot. Kamenskiy already had his Olympic quota spot, takes silver here, and Marco De Nicolo taking an Olympic quota spot as well as bronze medal here in New Delhi. We'll take a very short, short break. We'll be away for just a while, about half an hour or so, as we come back with our next final, the 10-meter air pistol men. at the Dr. Karni Singh Shooting Range, New Delhi. So just for the moment, for a few minutes, on behalf of Richard Drew and myself, Charu Sharma, and the entire production team, thank you for joining us. Do join us again in just a few minutes.
Lucy Perrell.
No.
Yeah.
I have to tell you about her as well.
I like her.
No, she's a really nice
I prefer
person.
Lucy than Amy.
No, Amy's the one.
She's more my idea of woman.